Hi everybody, I'm Dr. Aman Osman. I'm a community physician, assistant professor at medical colleges and university. My project title is Problem-Based Learning, Strengths and Challenges. As you know, problem-based learning is an innovative student-centered teaching method, and it's facilitated and promotes self-directing learning among students, promote effective critical thinking, and fosters the collaboration and sharing of information among students and motivate the lifelong learning process. It had been adopted by our college and they adopt modified hybrid PBL model and they use the seven-step jump step process from Maastricht University. To conduct an effective PBL session, it is required a good environment in which the jump steps are applied and every participant plays a role in professional, precise manner as it is explained in the diagram. PBL face a lot of challenges, that's why I thought about this project. And think about the main objective of this project was to assess both staff and student perception about PBL and to identify challenging facing the implementation process. Then according to the analysis, results. I will provide corrective and supportive intervention following by conduction of post-interventional survey. By now, the first step had been completed, and now the second step is operating, and the third final step is coming next. The results of my first survey showing that there were a negative perception from the faculty participated in the survey, and that mainly was due to the lack of proper training before implementation of PBL and the workload of PBL, since it required more time and efforts for adequate preparation for the session. And the results from the survey with the students, again, it shows negative perception for the PBL teaching methods, and that was shown in the figure number 4 in the poster. And it was mainly due to that they didn't have training before implementation of the session, and half of them, they record that they didn't understand the session objectives, and some of them, they mentioned that they were not actively participated in the learning process. This was the results from the first survey, and now we are conducting the interventional activity. And after that, we will conduct the second survey. Thank you very much.